Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting off today's video, there is yet another Falcon 9 launch with the Crew 4 mission. The booster which launched to this mission, B1067, then landed successfully for the fourth time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Fantastic view of the first stage. Landing legs have been deployed, returning back to Earth for a fourth time. Just like that, a fourth landing as part of the Crew 4 mission. You can hear the applause behind us.
In addition to there being another astronaut launch on a Crew Dragon capsule, there was a return from the ISS as well. Axiom posted some pictures of the crew of their AX-1 mission as they exited the Crew Dragon capsule having returned home safely. With all the Crew Dragon launches, I want to share this tweet from an NSF editor about the Dragon capsule SpaceX has. They have a cargo capsule under construction and two operational being refurbished, as well as four operational Crew Dragons now with the launch of Crew 4. There is another launch coming up this week with yet another Starlink mission scheduled to lift off. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 4-16 mission is scheduled to lift off on Friday 29th at 9:33pm UTC or 5:33pm EDT. There was an interesting tweet posted by Hawaiian Airlines related to Starlink. They said, "We are proud to be the first major US airline to select SpaceX's Starlink, which will provide the best internet connectivity in the air, free for our guests. Stay connected from the comfort of your seat. This is the future of flying." Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. SpaceX did some testing of the chopstick catching arms recently. Work has been going on with the Starship quick disconnect arm. Plumbing work has been going on at the orbital tank farm recently. There's been a whole bunch of propellant deliveries to the orbital tank farm. Of course, work also continues with the orbital launch mount. Crews continue to prepare the pad A mount at the suborbital launch site. Work has been going on with this new booster transport mount. Here's a view of the mega bay as work continues. More stairs were also lowered inside. Star Factory has been continuing to progress in the yard. Elon Musk posted this awesome picture of a whole load of Raptor 2 engines at Starbase. He said, "Raptor 2 rocket engines at Starbase, each producing over £500,000, 230 tons of force. The Starship 24 upper ring stack was moved inside the high bay. These booster propellant transfer tubes were delivered. You probably don't know, but Booster 7's downcomer pipe was damaged recently. I don't want to directly share the photo as it was leaked and not authorized, and it's also now removed from most places as a result. However, here's a part of an article about the leaked image where you can see the damage. It looks like SpaceX will be possibly fixing Booster 7. With the partial Booster 8 liquid oxygen tank outside, crews have continued working on it. As always, I have to say thank you to Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to Nick Antsuini, who was out there too, filming some of the Starbase content in this video. As well, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.